lies. All your life, all your life, all your best. When your daddy gonna talk to you? But you would live it. Alright, so the plan is, we're going to try and make the back of this car as comfortable as possible using loads of blankets, cushions, pillows, everything we have at our availability.
Ever since I was little, I've dreamed of just getting in a car or a van and driving off to some faraway place. It wouldn't matter where, in the end, I would go everywhere. It wouldn't matter who with, I'd meet them all along the way. Open roads in front of me and the setting sun behind. It wouldn't really be leaving home, because home was always at the next stop. Then, one day, I'd wake up to the crashing of the waves just meters away, and I would gaze out onto the horizon and think back to the day this all began, all them years ago. And yet, I'd barely begun. It's not the right moment for me to make this happen right now. I don't have the money or time, as I'm still at university. But what I do have is one full weekend and a car that I can make into a camper. The plan was to make the car as comfortable as possible to see if it would work as a camper. Drive to Saltburn by the Sea, a beach town 50 miles away. Sleep overnight and wake up in time for sunrise.
To be fair, that's not bad at all. Like, literally,
I'm lying fully straight now and I can fit inside.
And just like that, I was away, leaving my great city of Newcastle-upon-Tyne for the great unknown.
So I've decided to come get some fuel first before I go down there, because Saltburn by the Sea is pretty much in the sticks. I don't think there's a lot of petrol stations down there, and at the time of recording this video, like, literally one in three petrol stations have no petrol or diesel. Yeah, like Brexit and lorry drivers and things like that.
There you go.
Thank you. Why do I do this? I've just tried to do like a three-point turn in the most awkward street, driven up someone's driveway, crashed into a bush, basically lost my car wheels, but we're doing just fine. Anyways, so yeah, I've set up the camera in the car now so I can talk to you whilst I'm driving. We've just got here. Oh shit, the camera. After about an hour and a half driving, pretty uneventful, looking the wrong way, that would help. all that's happened is we went to McDonald's when we were in Middlesbrough, got a little bite to eat because I've got no food on me in the car. And yeah, so we're in Saltburn by the Sea right now, in the town centre. I'm just going to try and find the place that overlooks the seaside where we can park for free. There we go. Oh, hit the curb. Right, let's get out and have a look, eh? See what it's like. First impressions.
So there's actually a caravan right there and a van there, which makes me think whether people have the same idea, potentially, camping out on the seafront.
Wow.
So that bit there, pretty sure is the pier. A little bit nice, which is where we're going to go in the morning to catch a sunrise.
You can see the beach down there. So there is some like people walking about, but it's not too busy, to be fair. I like it. You know, I was actually quite nervous about coming in the first place, but now that I'm actually here, even though I'm by myself, I kind of like feel quite happy and excited for what's to come.
Yeah, I think I'm going to get the car set up now, get the bedding ready and the lights on.
Alrighty, the car is pretty much set up. I've put the blankets down, lights are up. The curtains are up, the DIY curtains on both sides. I'm not going to do the back window because it's steamed up anyways. And I've also got the parcel shelf here, which pretty much blocks most of the view anyways. And when I wake up, I want to be able to look out that window straight away with my head up here and be able to see the seaside or the sunrise, whatever it may be, in the morning. I don't know, it kind of feels quite weird. It feels really cozy. I didn't think it would be this nice, admittedly, when I got here. But I'm kind of like in love with the idea of doing this more often. So if this goes well tonight, you could well see me go on all along the northeast coast and beyond, and maybe one day even Europe. That'll be the plan. That'll be the dream. So we're settled in the car slash camper for the night. Not gonna lie, a lot of people, I haven't told anyone that I'm coming tonight apart from my aunties who I passed by their house on the way here. And the reason I've not told anyone that I'm doing this right now is because, frankly, a lot of people judge anything that is a little bit different. And I know sleeping in the boot of your car overnight in some random place, for most people, that would never ever cross their mind. And I'm not saying I'm scared of telling people that I'm doing this, but just, I feel like rather than telling before you do it, I would rather create this amazing video or create some nice photos or whatever and show them exactly what I'm doing before they have a chance to even think of the negatives of what sleeping in a car boot might look like. They probably, if I told them I was going to do this tonight, they would probably imagine me curled up in the boot of the car with literally no space, freezing cold, very little jacket, blankets. They definitely wouldn't picture fairy lights lighting up the entire inside of the car. I mean, it's literally so cozy right now. I guess the point I'm trying to make is, if you want to go out there and do something, even if that something is a little bit weird, wacky, random, something that most people wouldn't do, who gives a toss? Just get out there and do it. If it'll make you feel better or happier, do it. And you don't have to tell anyone what you're doing. Just go out there, and when you get back, show them the amazing pictures or photos or videos you've got. Or keep it a secret all to yourself. And let that just be something for you to do when you want to do. I don't know, I feel like I'm rambling right now, but you know what I'm trying to say.
Apparently I forgot to say goodnight at this point, so here it is, in retrospect. Goodnight, guys.
Right, so this is my view right now, this morning, and it is beautiful. It is currently 2 minutes past seven. The sun is due up in 8 minutes.
As I was going down these stairs, I ran into a man called Frank. We had a bit of a chat, and he actually asked me to record him. Here he is.
What's your name?
My name is Frank. I'm a Londoner. Moved up here because of the trouble and strife. Wife is from the area. I fell in love with it. I come down here regularly to pray and meditate, and let my soul gravitate to the love yard. Peace.
Me and Frank talked for a little bit longer once the cameras were off. He told me about how he came to this beach most mornings before sunrise, just to de-stress and get away from it all, and I get that. If I lived here, I would too. Anyways, as we said goodbye and I continued down the hill, I don't think I could have been prepared for the experience that happened over the next 2 hours. There was people on the beach already, walking the dogs and swimming, but as I walked onto the pier and got further and further away from the cliffside, the sun rose and reflected across the water beautifully, and something just changed. There was people around, and yet I felt like there was nobody there at all.
tell you stories of mine.
I don't know what it is, guys, but there's something about the sunrise which just makes it feel so, so, so very happy. It's like on an ordinary day, your energy and your happiness can be like midpoint, somewhere in the middle. But the minute you get up the sunrise, even if you're very tired, the feeling and the power of the sun and the warmth on your skin will literally just wake you up and rejuvenate you. Do I sound like a hippie or something? I don't know, but it's true. Feeling on top of this world. I've been here for about 2 hours now, and I'm not getting sick of being here at all. I think this is proof that you don't need to go far away, even leave the country, to have the kind of travel experiences that you want to have. I, along with you and probably most other people in the world, love the idea of one day just getting a van or a big car or getting on a plane and just going somewhere miles away. India, Africa, South America, anywhere away from here, wherever here is for you. But the fact is, even just going an hour away in the car, even just half an hour, this place took me an hour and 15 minutes or thereabouts to get to. And I haven't even left my area, which is the northeast. And yet I feel like I'm having some sort of experience with this sunrise that you only kind of dream of in far-flung lands. If you take one thing away from this video, take this: get out there, do things alone or with friends, and don't be scared of judgment. Sleep in the car boot, take a one-man tent, go and sleep, go and wake up on the middle of a beach in the middle of nowhere with just you and your stove and your food and your camera. If you don't want to be on camera, take a journal, take something to record your experiences whilst you're there, because there's nothing more beautiful than having something to look back on in the good times and the good moments of life.